Imagine going to your local grocery store in the middle of the afternoon to find a crime scene with five police departments.
Now that's what happened at the Hy-Vee on University in Windsor Heights yesterday. KCCI Cynthia Fodor has the details. Cynthia?
Stacey and Kevin, it's not the sort of thing a quiet neighborhood would ever expect to see. Enraged people swinging baseball bats at one another in a Hy-Vee parking lot.
And I walked out of that store and I looked up. I've never seen so many police and rescue units.
Roger Maxwell had just done a little shopping when he started snapping these photos on his cell phone.
I just couldn't believe what I was seeing. Ball bats were involved, and I don't know the damage done to a couple of cars that could not have been done by ball bats. I mean, it looks like somebody had run into somebody else.
Maxwell saw two injured on the ground as Hy-Vee customers gathered. Viewer Glenn Don also sent us photos.
We had really a quite large crime scene. As you can imagine, a major business in the middle of the day.
When Windsor Heights police arrived, eight people were involved in a brawl using baseball bats and other makeshift weapons. They called in Clive Police, Urbandale, West Des Moines, and the Sheriff's Office for backup.
There were obvious injuries to at least two of the parties that had been struck in the head with baseball bats, and there were some other additional scrapes and bruises, but as you can imagine, in those sorts of situations, everyone is pretty hyped up, and so it took time to calm down.
Five people have been arrested. 26-year-old Vaccaro Butts charged with assault with intent to injure. 22-year-old John Butts and 23-year-old William Freeman with assault causing injury. 37-year-old Jelani Green and 23-year-old Lindsay Williams face disorderly conduct charges. Police say some of the individuals may be affiliated with gangs, but this was not motivated through gang activity.
It's obvious that the parties involved knew one another and that there was an ongoing conflict. So. Who lured who, where, and why and for what motive, that's still being sorted through at this point.
Two people had to be hospitalized for head wounds. Police say they are still trying to determine what caused the fight to break out in the first place. If you have any information or cell phone photos, you're asked to contact Polk County Crime Stoppers. Stacy?
Cynthia, thank you.